Hello everyone, welcome back to another video from Exotic Astrology. And I have been getting so many messages for this eclipse which happened yesterday, and so finally I have decided to make a video on the phenomena of eclipses. Okay, what does eclipse mean and how does it affect us, or how should it affect us, how should we see it and how should we not see it? Okay, so this eclipse, well, first of all, what is an eclipse? I won't go into the astronomy, but if I have to summarize as per astrology, eclipse is the time when either the sun or the moon, which represents us, right? Sun is the self and moon is our mind. They come under the influence of the nodes of the moon. Who are they? Rahu and Ketu, yes? Rahu explodes, Ketu sucks him, okay? Rahu's energy is a very disruptive, exploding, bomb-blasting energy. Something from the past. Ketu is also from the past, but Ketu represents those things which suck us down, which pull us down. And when this happens with the sun and moon, okay, it is considered disastrous. Because when it happens over, when Ketu and Rahu eclipse the sun and moon, what happens is we get challenged inside as a person. Yes, if it's happening over the sun, we can have difficulty finding ourselves, difficulty seeing the right things, difficulty in understanding what is happening with us. Okay, and when this happens over the moon, okay, not over the moon, when the moon gets eclipsed, then what happens? We have difficulty feeling happy. Yes, when it happens with Ketu especially, because Ketu has sucked all the light of the moon. Okay, so especially when difficult times like these come, okay, we need to be very patient and we need to understand that these keep happening over 6 months once the eclipse keeps happening. Okay, and now the major solar eclipse is going to come on 21st of this month, okay, after 15 days almost. So basically the eclipse which was there yesterday was with Ketu. Okay, moon was almost being eclipsed by Ketu. Actually it is getting eclipsed today, but because it was directly in front of sun yesterday, so that is why we call it an eclipse. Okay, I will go into detail of what is an eclipse and when the eclipse is formed, what is solar eclipse, what is lunar eclipse later. But I just wanted to make a video on the essence of eclipse in astrology. So basically the eclipses mean that there are some fated events. Am I clear? There are some fated, destined events from our past which is destined to come and which is destined to happen. Okay. Why fated? Because they are happening over the, they happen with the sun and moon, which represents ourselves, right? So those things which we have carried, okay, Rahu Ketu is our past and sun and moon is we. Okay, so we are connected to our past lives. Okay, billions of lifetimes we have spent in this material world doing so many things. So especially when the eclipse happens, when it is a lunar eclipse, people tell me that we don't feel like living anymore, we just feel that that's it. I was getting messages yesterday from so many people, from the week, in fact from last 15 days I am getting messages. And even I am also feeling the heat of the eclipse. Because the moon now feels that it doesn't exist. So basically what it means when there's an eclipse, we feel as if that the areas where we are emotionally connected to, okay, it can be our family, our friends, our mother, our wife, our husband, our boyfriend, our girlfriend, or whoever it is, or our children, wherever we find emotional satisfaction, emotional nourishment, those areas disappear from our life. That is what happens. Or it may not disappear. We feel as if that area has gone down from our lives. Okay? And especially the yesterday's eclipse was over the nakshatra of Shravan. Moon was transiting Shravan nakshatra. And what Shravan represents? Shravan represents hearing. Shravana. Shravan means to hear. Okay? So basically what this eclipse means, what it meant yesterday, and the eclipse, the effect of the eclipse, the lunar eclipse will stay for some time. What it means basically is that, of course, it has many meanings and it will depend as per your horoscope where this is happening, where is the sign of Capricorn falling, because Capricorn people have been severely affected by this, I know. So primarily this shows that wherever Capricorn is falling, okay, in those areas when we have tried to find fulfillment, we have either faced terrible challenges or some things related to that area has come to a completion, because it was a full moon yesterday. Full moon means what? The moon is getting brighter and brighter and brighter. Yes, did you notice yesterday's moon? So that's what was happening yesterday. So things are coming into completion. So that means if something was falling apart, it has finally fallen. Yes, because the act of falling is completed. And then when it got completed, full moon, suddenly Ketu, because Ketu is very near, Ketu is in the last, in the beginning degrees of Aquarius, and moon is somewhere here in Capricorn, so they are very near. So what we thought has now been shattered. And that process of shattering has completed because it was a full moon and Ketu is there. And what is Ketu? Ketu is that headless planet where it does not see anything. It's just going from here to there, searching things. Or maybe it is this way, maybe it is that way. So that is why these eclipses have been given very much prominence in the Vedic scriptures, especially in the world of astrology. Of course, there are predictions which people make that, oh, the world is going to change, this is going to happen, that is going to happen. No, that is not going to happen. That happens, of course, but we may not feel that so much because that depends on our individual horoscope, the dasha which we are undergoing, and the other transits of planets. For example, Jupiter is very soon going to go to the sign of Libra. So, that will have a different flavor. Saturn is retrograde now. So, we have to combine all the factors, but I am speaking of only the moon here now. My agenda is not to speak on what is happening in your life. Nor am I wanting to speak this will happen, that will happen. Or nor am I asking you, did you undergo something? I am not asking. I am not concerned with what is happening to each and every individual here. I am only concerned about how to help everybody during these difficult times. Because those things which give us hope, which will give us the feeling of being happy, those things could have been shattered yesterday. Many people I know. And when I say yesterday, I don't mean yesterday as a date, but from many days I have been seeing. And then I see ultimately that yesterday things have come to the surface. Because it's full moon, you are fully able to see that. And then when Ketu eclipses it, you are like shattered. Because suddenly you realize it is not what you thought. It is not the way how you perceived it. That pains us, right? Yes, it pains me also. But what to do? That's the norm of the planets. Eclipses keep happening over 6 months. So, what is the remedy I would suggest? Remedy is, this is a very powerful time to start something new in our spiritual life. Whichever religion we are, whichever tradition we have been following, or whichever tradition our parents have followed, or whichever path we feel connected to. If you are a Hindu, if you are watching this, Hindu as per definition of what is called a Hindu. If you are a Muslim, if you are a Christian, then especially if you are Christian, then probably this Sunday you should visit the church. And if you are a Muslim, probably this Friday you should visit the mosque. And you should go and take advice from saintly people, the father in the church. You should go and ask them that I am facing difficulty, this emotional trauma is coming in my life. Difficulty feeling happy basically. Moon is the feeling of contentment, happiness, peace, belonging, wanting to live. It is a sign of the mother. The mother always says, I will care for you, irrespective of whatever you do with me. Right? Only the mother can say that. Nobody else says that. Yes. So, this is a time to introspect into ourselves. If this, what we have found shattering into pieces, if they shatter, will give us fulfillment in the long run. And as I said, Shravan is referring to hearing. So we should go and hear the good advice of the saintly people, whoever they are. And saintly people, I do not mean you just go to YouTube and you just Google, oh, how to solve this problem, how to solve that problem. People who are authorized in the words of the scriptures. People who you know, whose lives you have seen that they have followed and they have changed their own lives and they have changed others' lives. It is not anybody. Because that's another thing we can do, because this has happened in Shravan Nakshatra. Then the other paradox comes. We can just go on asking advice from anywhere. But Shravan also refers to Lord Vishnu, because Lord Vishnu is the controlling deity of the Shravan Nakshatra. And Vishnu is God himself. So this is an indication that this is the time we should take to spirituality. Because whatever we were, whatever conceptions of happiness we had, most of the people, those things have been shattered. So the Shravan Nakshatra is actually telling you that, my dear sir, it might happen that if you don't go to God, if you don't hear, see, Shravan is hearing the ears. If you do not hear the message of the Gita, the Quran, the Bible, the Torah, the Dharmapada of the Buddhists, or whichever tradition you are following, something you do. Otherwise, you have seen what can happen. It's a terrible disaster. There was a girl who messaged me yesterday that she doesn't want to live anymore. It is very bad. Well, I will not share what happened with her because it's just a detail. But the point I'm trying to say is life gets tough sometimes. And when we have expectations that this will be like this and then it turns out to be something else, then things can go haywire. There's complete mayhem. And this can happen so many times in our life. So when this happens, where do we fall back to? Always ask this question, where is the shelter? Where are you going when there is difficulty? Are you resorting to drugs, to alcohol, to smoking, to watching pornography, or watching reality shows in the internet, or in the TV, or you are taking shelter in things like different serials and sequences which are there in the internet? No. I won't take names. So many series I see in the internet, people are watching and gossiping and just not knowing what they are doing. The question is hearing all those things from YouTube or from the TV or from that movie, is it going to help you? I think you have got the answer. If it would have helped you, this chaos would have not happened. People would have not been calling and saying like this. That means their inner substance is very weak. Everybody, including me. And that's okay. We are all human beings. We have difficulties. There's no problem with that. That's perfectly fine. The problem is when we don't go to the place where we have the solution. Solution is where? Solution is in God. So it is a wonderful time to start something new in our spiritual life. Because there's this another solar eclipse which is happening on 21st of this month. It is directly happening over the United States. So that is why I am stressing on this point, to start something new spiritually, so that the next time when such calamity happens, okay, we can have something to fall back to. We can realize that, okay, I have this. Even if this doesn't work, God is always there. God will always work. Otherwise you can be miserable. And I was overwhelmed by the amount of responses I was getting from people. And I was like, what can I do? I can't just go to your life and keep solving your problems individually. And even if I try, it cannot happen. Because people are not connected to the right source. And those who are connected, I have seen them. It has not affected them much. Who are strong spiritually. Spiritually strong does not mean you are just doing something and you say, oh yes, I am very strong spiritually. What is your definition of spiritual strength? That is most important. Are you finding shelter in God, in reading about Him, in discussing about Him, in bringing people closer to Him? Are you finding shelter in associating with those people who are close to Him? A boy is close, when a boy gets close to a girl, then when the girl gets close to the boy, then they fall in love with each other. So are you in love with God? Or are you in love with Game of Thrones? Or the new football game? Sorry to hurt anybody's sentiments. There's no offense here. I don't mean any offense to anybody. Or is our shelter coming from, I don't know, maybe some new movie which is going to come. Maybe some actor. Can these people help us? Well, that's for you to introspect, okay? So, eclipses are nothing but a call for a new beginning. Because whenever we see our own karma, we get threatened. Because there are so many sins which we have committed in the past. Only God can save us, okay? So, save yourself and save the people around you by starting something new today. Beautiful day today is. Today the nakshatra of Dhanishtha is running. Dhanishtha is what about celebrations? Celebrate this day today. Do not miss this day today. Do not let Dhanishtha nakshatra be wasted. I always wait when Dhanishtha nakshatra will come. I am celebrating with sweets today. I don't know why. Just because Dhanishtha is running. Dhanishtha is what drums. Moon is transiting Dhanishtha now. In Germany. So I am just celebrating. So you also celebrate. Don't deprive yourself from the celebration. But celebrate how? By starting something new. Go to the temple and buy some holy book. Buy the Bhagavad Gita and study. Go to the church. Purchase the Quran and the Bible and you start reading. Go to the mosque and meet that old person. That holy person. Go and ask him, what does Allah say in the Quran? What does Muhammad say? What did he hear from Allah? If you have read it, then read it again 10 times. Celebrate the Quran today. And make life beautiful. So that's it from my side. If you have any questions, queries or comments about eclipses, then please let me know in the comment section. And if not, then always remember, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and He will be there. Okay? Until next time, bye bye. See you.